Should I start? You can you see my screen?
Yes, Pavlos, go.
Okay. So this is the demo for the Adaptable Distributed Storage. Actually, we have prepared two demos. One has been already provided to you in recorded to you, but we demonstrate the second part here, which actually is based on the first one. So what is Adaptable Distributed Storage is actually what I was telling you is that the CAP theorem claims that they have only two properties can be ensured in database management systems. So CAP theorem is about consistency, high availability, partition and tolerance. What happens is that no SQL data stores can scale out online, but they do not ensure consistency as they don't force transactions. So they lack of the C property. On the other hand, relational database management systems offer transactions and ensure the asset properties. So the C in the asset properties, the consistency, but they either cannot scale online, so they miss the P of the partition and tolerance attribute, or when they do scale, they cannot do it in an online manner. So it's, they must do it offline, or when they try to do it, the implications of the performance are very, very important. And as a result, we cannot consider that they actually ensure the high availability. So what we have done, this is the innovation of this task, is that in Big Data Stack, with this Adaptable Distributed Storage, we ensure we claim to ensure all the three properties of the CAP theorem, so we can provide elastic scalability with no impact neither in transactions nor in the performance. Okay, we have provided in the recording with the demo one. So there, well, just very briefly, I will tell you that just to recall that there we have actually the logical databases that we fragment into horizontal partitions that we call it regions, and we execute in an online manner, split, moving, and merge of the regions across the data nodes. And we saw there in this demo that we have no performance implication. And actually we validate this using an OLTP operational workload, make use of the industry standard of the TPCC. We saw that we assure the data consistency and transactions without implication of the performance. So this demo, we separate the demo because the purpose is a little bit different. So the demo here is actually will be built on top of what we have, what about these basic pillars that we have in demo one. So there, I will demonstrate actually the elastic scalability of our solution, which means that the distributed storage can self-adapt online. And we actually scale in or out to actually adapt to diverse workloads. This is going to be based on the pillars that demonstrated in the demo one, and we'll see how, first of all, we don't have any performance implications as we scale out, and we'll use a very heavy data ingestion, ensuring that we have data consistency in transactions. The data ingestion will be relied on the demo of Kranaos and the scenario of Kranaos. So what is actually the purpose of this scenario? The Kranaos organization has a fleet of vessels. So as Stathis explained before, the vessel produces hundreds of IoT records per second from the various sensors deployed in any vessel. So even if we have a small fleet, this means that we have thousands of insertions per second. But we can safely assume that the number of vessels traveling across the globe are pretty steady for a long period, because it's very difficult to buy and sell vessels very often. However, it might change. Because this type of organizations actually might need to sell or buy their vessel. This might be for the different reasons. One is for instance, to liquefy their assets, take advantage, for instance, what happened during the economic crisis. All this type of organizations prefer to sell the vessels as during the crisis, cargo was not bought very often. And then, so it means that they sell a lot of their fleet and then they renew the fleet to buy more and to take advantage later on. Also, for now, with the COVID restrictions, there might be also the traveling restrictions. Even if we are not targeting a cargo fleet organization, we might have other similar that actually make commercial travelings. So what happens is that the ingestion rate puts different requirements from time to time. And actually, the number of vessels affects the amount of incoming workload that needs to be served by the database management system. And if we are focusing now in the Kranaos use case, we can safely say that the scenario is valid to all the other sectors. For instance, if we have the Eroski use case, this is going to be something equivalent to having an extent and a significant increase of clients during, for instance, the Christmas period, that usually you have five times or something similar, five times more the expected traffic. So you have a steady traffic that has been increased for a long period. So what we're going to use in this demo, first of all, we're going to make use of the LeanXcale operational data store, would be going to be the data management layer. And this going to make use of the Adaptable Distributed Storage that has been implemented in the project. This contains the following functionalities. Firstly, a self-monitoring mechanism to be able to identify when there's a need to scale out. They have a decision support algorithm that actually when we scale in or out, so we have different type of resources. We run this algorithm, decide about a new distribution of the data load, which means the data regions. The scale provision is being based on the virtualized containers. And we have also an internal process for live data migration that actually ensures the transactions under the operational workloads. We have also integrated with a Grafana monitoring dashboard to be able for you to show what happens as we scale out. And we need to also highlight there that this adaptable distributed storage has already been added into the LeanXcale commercial product and it's being used actually by our customers as we speak. We also have a traffic simulator that sends IoT sensor data from the vessels as it would be in a real scenario. But we decided to do this because it would take a lot of time to having an end-to-end integration and have to wait for the workload to actually reach LeanXcale. So we have this simulator to actually sense exactly the same, but we can directly change the incoming load for the purpose of the demo. So what we're going to do here, we're going to instantiate all the storage in a single node. The data will start to be ingesting for a small number of vessels, and then we increase the number of vessels, and we'll notice that the metric values has been increasing a lot. This is going to make the monitoring engine to identify the need for the scaling, for the scale out, and then we're going to see live that a new data node is going to be provided. That also we have the automation of the splitting of a data region and move it online. And you can see how the overall performance has been distributed equally into the two different nodes. And now I'm giving the floor to Diego. Diego, are you ready, mate?
Yes.
Okay, I'll stop sharing.
Okay, so I will share the screen. Okay, are you seeing it?
Yes, man.
Okay. So yes, in this case, I have here so this is running with Docker Compose. So we have, as Pablo said, one instance for the node that is storing the data in LeanXcale. So there's the storage engine node, and we have another node for the rest of the components. So in this demo, we will scale the node, the devote to the storage engine. So here first I start, so this is a graph with the ingestion rate, and here I start the simulator that Pavlos mentioned with just one vessel, so simulating the load of one vessel, and here I started six vessels. So here is the accumulated load that LeanXcale is receiving, or this node is receiving, this storage engine node is receiving, and as we can see here, the trend has increased. Because it's receiving more load from the simulator. Okay, so now I'm going to start 20 vessels, and this will trigger the elastic process we have. So we will detect that the metrics have changed and the trend has changed. So we are going to have a new KVTS instance, a new storage engine instance, sorry. And this storage instance will receive half of the load because we will split the regions that it's accumulating all this load ingested by the clients. And we will have two different data store instances receiving this load. So the load will be distributed among both of them. Okay, so here we can see that the ingestion rate is being increased. because it takes like 1 minute to fulfill the request of the client, simulating the clients. And here we should see that the scalability has been triggered. Okay, so here we have detected the trend, and as we can see here, it has, okay, I'm going to. Okay, so this is when I had the trend when I had 6 vessels, and now I have. And now here I have 20. So here, as you can see, we have 2 new data store instances, and the load has been distributed among both of them. And the ingest ratio has increased, and it's and the client is processing all the and it's processing all the queries that the client is running. So here it has triggered the elasticity, and it's divided among both servers. So now the load is stable because, as I said, the client takes some time to stabilize the load, and now it's divided among both servers. So that's it. I'm not sure if Pablo, do you want to add something?
I just have one slide to conclude. So I share again. So actually what we saw here is that Adaptable Distributed Storage is capable to dynamic access resources. So actually we do provide the elastic scalability. We have, as we saw, the self-monitoring mechanism that when it takes these metrics decide to scale out. So the new resources were dynamically requested. The scale out take place when actually the resources were acquired. This automatically triggered the split of one or two of the data regions, and they were moved to the data nodes. But we have actually load balancing of the workload, as you saw in the demo, with no actual intervention of any of the DBA admin. So what we saw here, what we evaluated, is that we ensure all the 3 properties of the CAP theorem. So we do it in a fully transactional manner, where actually no SQL systems fail, and we have actually no performance penalty, and we can do it in the runtime, where it is actually where the other part of the database family, the SQL operational system, fail. And that's for this demo. Any comments, Dimo, Joseph?
I think that's okay, but having listened to that, and you know the CAP theorem and everything we discussed in the morning, I mean in the workforce session. Okay, the only point is that no, leave it as is. I know you go super fast, Ferrari, in the review for the
group.
Okay. Pablo, I have to go.
Close to start this, right?
Yeah, please, because I was telling some business parts that you were telling me privately some time ago, but tell me.
Yes. On some slide, I can't remember the number of the slide, you were saying some things about the sensors on board and the time granularity. Yes, it's not per second, it's per minute, the first bullet.
Okay.
Okay, and on the second thing about buying vessels, we will be very happy if that happens quite frequently. But remember that the services we're demonstrating here are sold as a service. So we have contractual agreements with other shipping companies that intend to use our services. And this is how the number of vessels will increase, not via us buying new vessels. Customers, let's say, ingested into our platform.
Okay. Thanks, Stathi. I will update. Sure.
Pavlos, I think there is, first of all, it was really nice, but I think that there is one slide missing, which is a summary of the demo that you do not show. You can't assume that the reviewers have already viewed your first demo. So that's a bit of a problem.
Okay, because I have this only for a recap. Put an additional slide with some more details and some screenshots of the previous demo to put it there.
Yes, I have another question. I recall, so do we show anything else regarding the use case?
Yeah, we have George.
Yeah, hi.
And Stathis.
And Stathis.
George. Okay, George, let's go.
Okay, let me share my screen.